A 2016 study has confirmed the presence of Nile crocodiles surviving in the wild of South Florida. Native to a broad region of the African continent, the Nile crocodile, or Crocodilus niloticus, is among the deadliest apex predators on this planet. Growing up to 6 meters, or almost 20 feet in length, this is one of the few wild animals that will regularly look at a human being and think, yeah, that could be prey. The researchers cite a figure that there were at least 493 attacks on humans, leading to 354 fatalities between 2010 and 2014. Nile crocodiles are more dangerous to humans than the native crocodilians of Florida, such as the American alligator. In this study, published in the Journal of Herpetological Conservation and Biology, 4 unusual-looking crocodiles were captured in South Florida between 2000 and 2014. Researchers used DNA matching to show that at least 2 of these were indeed Nile crocodiles, most closely related to a population found in South Africa. Identical genetic markers indicate that at least 2 of these animals were directly related to one another, meaning they probably came from the same source, but what was the source? It's a mystery. So, whoever is bringing Nile crocodiles to Florida and releasing them, please, please stop, okay? Stop. By tracking the growth, movement, and foraging behaviors of one of the animals, researchers also confirmed that Nile crocodiles can not only survive in the wild in Florida, they seem to be doing extremely well. One specimen that was recaptured after a period in the wild had grown 40.5 centimeters, or about 16 inches per year, 28% faster than some Nile crocodiles in their native range. So it's possible that we have found a glorious king crocodile incubator, and it's Florida. The researchers stressed that there's no evidence of an established population of Nile crocodiles in the wilderness of Florida, but there's also no way to be sure that the ones we found in this study were alone. In 30 years, are we going to be reading reports of Nile crocodiles feasting on our South Florida cattle and Everglades tourists? I guess we'll wait and see. I do want to emphasize that there is not currently a known danger of Nile crocodile attacks in Florida. The real story here isn't about killer crocodiles, but about the broader problem of invasive species. Florida already has the greatest number of invasive amphibians and reptiles of any place in the world, including animals like the Burmese python. So, what do you think should be done about the problem of invasive species? Especially in Florida, where they really seem to feel at home. Let us know in the comments, and to hear more stories like this, check out now.howstuffworks.com every day.